all the boats to go as a state from around the globe sending
the gathering of the United Nations in New York due to the coronavirus pandemic.
And quickly spoke of China and the COVID-19 pandemic.
75 years after the end of World War II and the founding of the United Nations, we are once again engaged in a great global struggle. We have waged a fierce battle against the invisible enemy, the China virus, which has taken countless lives in 188 countries.
Chinese ambassador to the United Nations, Tom and
Sharon, turned here to an interpreter
who feeds his
presence to
Mars. I'm not looking for the spreading of political virus.
Tuesday,
where Chinese President Xi Jinping, Russian President Vladimir Putin,
and South Korean President Moon Jae-in,
French President Emmanuel Macron, via this interpreter,
North Korea.
It is up to us to fulfill in time and over time
to ensure the weapon, but also
to ensure that we bring a response to Iran, so this is a call to destabilization in the region. Turning to North Korea now, we have supported efforts undertaken by the United States of America to allow commitment and undertaking of negotiation. Even if tangible results have not yet been achieved, the initiative of a president. What we're looking for now is treatment and engagement by North Korea.
Iranian President Hassan Rouhani, through an interpreter, is issue with the current state that the 2015 nuclear deal is in. This is why they have the infamy of being the sole users of atomic bombs in the history of humanity.
And while the
is running the non-proliferation theater.
Additional remarks were given by leaders in the afternoon.
Now for more on the day's activities, I spoke with VOA UN correspondent Margaret Bashir.
So the UN General Assembly annual debate got underway on Tuesday. We heard from some of the world's major powers, from Russia, from China, from France, four of the five permanent members of the Security Council, all represent the federal president. This year's assembly is a video message because of the COVID pandemic, but the pandemic was certainly foremost in the leaders' minds. There was a big focus on the race for the vaccine. President Trump said issues of the vaccine coming very soon in the United States. President Xi Jinping of China said that they have several COVID-19 vaccines in active phase 3 clinical trials in their country. And President Putin touted the fact that Russia is the first country to register a vaccine against COVID in August. And he said that he would like to offer it to the United Nations to have a vaccinated staff who are out in the field helping people. But I think it's important to note that the National Vaccine because it was approved when it hadn't even started these advanced phase 3 trials yet. So there's no question of whether it's effective or safe. But this is very much on the top of the agenda of the major powers today.
Speaking of COVID-19, President Trump really has laid out his case that China is responsible for the worldwide pandemic. And we have heard some of the response from the UN ambassador from China saying that they reject that assertion. But since the General Assembly and everyone is sharing their thoughts, where does the world stand on this question?
I think the United States is certainly more vocal in pointing the finger. We have heard it from some European leaders, but the rest of the world is a little more quiet about it. They don't, some countries, some developing countries, can't just avert the voice of the person. He speaks to colors. So, it was interesting because the messages were pre-taped. You know, when you had a live debate, a leader could hear the speech of